Hello students, in this video I'll be discussing about the singular value decomposition. Let A be any m cross n matrix. It can be factored as A equal to U sigma V transpose, where U is, now this being M cross N, U will be M cross M orthogonal modal matrix of A transpose. V will be n cross n orthogonal modal matrix of A transpose A. Now sigma as this is a m cross n matrix with square roots of non-zero eigenvalues of A transpose A and A transpose. Now A transpose whole transpose is same as A transpose A transpose, which is A transpose. That means the products here A transpose and A transpose A will be a symmetric matrix. As an example, we take construct the singular value decomposition of A equal to 4, 11, 14, 8, 7, minus 2. Now the steps involved are as follows. Now the first step would be to find A transpose or A transpose A. Now A is 2 cross 3. This implies A transpose will be 2 cross 2 and A transpose A will be 3 cross 3. So we choose matrix of smaller dimension for convenience. Now, step 2 would be find eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the chosen matrix. So we have A transpose that is equal to 4, 11, 14, 8, 7, minus 2, 4, 11, 14, 8, 7, minus 2, which will be equal to 333, 81, 81, 117. Now determinant A transpose minus lambda I will be equal to lambda squared minus 450 lambda plus 32400 equal to 0. So lambda equal to 360 and 90. Now step 3 would be construct D. D will be a diagonal matrix with lambda 1 greater than lambda 2 greater than lambda 3, that is arranged in a descending order. So we have lambda 1 equal to 360, lambda 2 equal to 90. So D equal to 360, 0, 0, 90. Now, sigma equal to square root of D this should be M cross N. That is sigma should be same size as A. The zeros here are added according to requirements. So sigma is, now the element wise root D is operated element wise. And since D is a diagonal matrix, square root of D will be square root of lambda 1, 0, square root of lambda 2. So this will be (6√10, 3√10, 0, and 0). Now since we want sigma to be 2/3, we add a zero column at the end. Now step 4 would be find eigenvectors of A transpose. Now A transpose is 333, 81, 81, 117. Now lambda equal to 360. This implies A transpose minus lambda I. That is, this is equal to minus 27, 81, 81, minus 243. So A transpose minus 360 I, this is minus 1, 3, 1, minus 3. So with this reduces to, so A transpose minus 360 I into x equal to 0 implies minus x plus 3y is 0, y equal to k implies x equal to 3k. So we choose x1 to be 3, 1. Similarly, lambda equal to 90 implies A transpose minus 90 I equal to 43, 81, 81, minus 27. This will be plus 27. Again, this is similar to 3, 1, 3, 1, which reduces to 3, 1, 0, 0. A transpose minus 90 I into x equal to 0. This implies 3x plus y equal to 0. This implies y equal to minus 3k implies x equal to k. So x2 equal to k 1 minus 3. Now inner product of x1, x2 is 0, so they are orthogonal. Inner product of x1 with x1, this is 3 squared plus 1, which is 10. And inner product of x2 with x2 will be 1 squared plus minus 3 squared, which is 10. So norm of x1 equal to root 10 and norm of x2 equal to root 10. Since these are the eigenvectors of A transpose, they form the matrix U. So matrix U is given by x1 by norm x1 and x2 by norm x2. So this will be 3 by root 10, 1 by root 10, 1 by root 10 minus 3 by root 10. Now A equal to U sigma B transpose. Now U transpose equal to I, since it is an orthogonal matrix, therefore U transpose A equal to sigma V transpose. Or A transpose U equal to B sigma transpose. So VI will be 1 by sigma I A transpose UI. Now sigma I is square root of lambda I. So V1 is 1 by sigma 1 A transpose UI. Now A is 4, 11, 14, 8, 7, minus 2. U is 3 by root 10, 1 by root 10, 1 by root 10, minus 3 by root 10. So we have V1 equal to 1 by 6 root 10 into 4, 11, 14, 8, 7, minus 2 into U1 is 3 root 10, 1 by root 10. So this will be 40 by root 10 40 by root 10, which will simplify to 1 by 3 2 by 3 2 by 3. Similarly, V2 is 1 by sigma 2 A transpose UI, which will be 1 by 3 root 10 into 4, 8, 11, 7, 14, minus 2 into U2 will be 1 by root 10 minus 3 by root 10. This will be 1 by 3 root 10 into 20 by root 10 minus 10 by root 10 plus 20 by root 10. So V2 will be 2/3 minus 1/3 2/3. Now V equal to V1, V2, V3. This should be a 3x3 matrix. We have V1 and V2. Now V is modal matrix of A transpose A. Now A transpose A equal to (4, 8, 11, 7, 14) -2 (4, 11, 14, 8, 7) -2, which is 80, 100, 40, 170, 140, 40, 140, and 200. Now eigenvalues of A transpose and A transpose A will repeat. Therefore, (λ1) equal to 360, (λ2) equal to 90, (λ3) we need to find. So (λ1) plus (λ2) plus (λ3) is 4/A, which is 450. This implies (λ3) is 0. (λ3) equal to 0 implies A transpose A minus (λi) is A transpose A . You can verify that the echelon form will be 2, 7, 10, 0, 1, 2, 0, 0, 0. So A transpose A into X equal to 0 implies 2X plus 7Y plus 10Z equal to 0, Y plus 2Z equal to 0, Z equal to K implies Y equal to minus 2K and X equal to 2K. So x is 2k minus 2k k. So x3 will be 2 minus 2, 1, which implies v3 is x3 by norm of x3, which will be 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3, 1 by 3. So v equal to 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3, 1 by 3, minus 2 by 3, 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3, 1 by 3.